Hello, my name is Ricardo Silveira. I'm professor at Federal University of Ouro Preto, Minas Gerais, Brazil, and I bring to you this paper, Advanced Numerical Study of Composite Steel Concrete Structures at High Temperature. This work is part of Rafael Barros' thesis, and we also had the collaboration of Dalila Pires from Federal University of São João del Rei, and the collaboration of Igor Lemes from Federal University of Lavras. So this presentation is organized in this way. First, we have the objective. After the expansion of our computational program, the thermal analysis, the thermal structural analysis, numerical application, and final remarks. So the main goal here is to study the behavior of composite steel concrete structures at high temperature using our homemade computer program CSASA. Actually, we made expansion on this computational program, including two modules. The first one, the fire analysis, where we make a finite element thermal analysis in permanent and transient regime. In the second module, the fire structural analysis, where we obtain the interaction diagrams under fire and make the inelastic second order analysis under fire. In terms of classification and inelastic behavior, we actually make a coupling between the strain-compatible method plus refined plastic method. But before to talk about these two modules, let me give you a general overview about our fire analysis. First, we make a structural analysis at home temperature when the fire starts. After that, we have a time cycle where we have the time increment. For each time increment, we solve or we make the thermal analysis where we obtain the temperature field and the properties of material in fire. Second, we make the structural analysis at high temperature, and as a product of this analysis, we have the interaction diagrams, and also we have the displacement, internal force, and other results. So we ask here for if the time cycle finished. If no, we repeat all the process. If yes, we go out and print all the results. So let me give you now some information about the sectional analysis related with the thermal study. So we solve at the cross-section level this transient heat condition equilibrium equation using one of these nonlinear solver strategy, considering different boundary condition, as you can see, different condition related with the thermal load. And the thermal structural analysis is related with an inelastic second order analysis of structures in fire condition. So we consider large displacement and plasticity. Related with plasticity or inelastic behavior, we actually make a coupling between strain compatible method and the refined plastic ring method. The first one, we have a cross-section strain level calculation, and after that, we obtain the generalized axial and bending stiffness, which is used in to obtain the plasticity in nodal term using actually this generalized stiffness parameter obtaining using SCM method. To give more details, the SCM method use moment curvature relationship. So when we have a cross section under axial force and bending moment, we can build the moment curvature relationship. So first in this relationship, we obtain the constitutive matrix, and after that, we solve this equation to obtain the axial strain and curvature. With this information, we can calculate the internal force using each contribution of the steel, concrete, and rebar, as you can see. After that, we can calculate the unbalanced force and ask and test the convergence. If yes, if okay, the process finished. If no, we have the iterative process using Newton-Raphson, and at the convergence point, we analyze the constitutive matrix to obtain the generalized axial stiffness and the generalized bending stiffness using this expression. So we make this in each node of the element, node I and node J. So you can see the element used in our program in the co-rotational system, where the force displacement relationship is given for this expression. So each term in the stiffness matrix in this system is given by this expression, where we have the axial stiffness and the bending stiffness evaluating each node, as I said. Here is included the second order term based on Young and Kuhn formulation. So the first example is a beam, a composite beam, with we tested two cross section, CB1 and CB2, where CB2 we have encased partial encased beam, as you can see. We used 8 finite element in the discretization of this problem. Both a cross section was we had a uniform heating, and the thermal and material property we consider EC4. This example was first analyzed by Landesmann and Safir, and it's very important to say that this psi we consider 20, 40, 60, 80% of F. So we had for each cross section 4 different load level. F is obtained when we have the section ultimate bending moment capacity for ambient temperature. The result of this problem for CB1, when we check what happened with the displacement with time for these 4 different levels, we compare here our result, our numerical result, with the Landesmann and Safir. And as you can see, for these 4 different load level, a good agreement between our result with literature. The CB2 result is also showed compared the displacement V at the center of the beam with time, and again we have the results for the 4 different load level. Again, a good agreement was observed between our results and the Landesmann and Safir. The second example is a composite column with this cross section, where we consider 4 different values of A, in other words, 4 different cross-section, but square cross-section. The numerical result of this problem was published by Huang et al. And again, we consider the standard fire design curve, uniform heating, and the thermal and material problem following the EC4. For each section here, we consider, as you can see, four different axial load level. The result of this problem is shown in this figure, where we follow what happened with the lateral displacement u here with the time. Again, our numerical results has a very, very good agreement with the literature results. So I would like to say that all these problems, we have another one in the paper. In all these analyses, we have a very good agreement with the literature results. And the numerical methodology proposed was very, very efficient to obtain the cross-section thermal behavior and thermal structural results. So as a future research, we can say about the analysis of timber structures under fire, new strategy for sectional analysis, and the spalling effect. So we have the support of our universities. The first one, Federal University of Ouro Preto, Federal University of Lavras, and Federal University of São João del Rey, all of them in Minas Gerais State. So I would like to say thank you very much. And we also had the support of federal research agencies and Minas Gerais State Agency. So thank you very much for this the support, and thank you very much for your attention.